Bakay correspondence for GL3 Kawamata Sensing.
So that does not overlap the Varia and the Fernando for this complex. So I'd like to talk about some derived Bakay correspondence and some related topics. So there are two ingredients. The first one is derived Bakay correspondence for SL2C. So this is due to Kapranov and Vassero, based on the work of Springberg. So this is the following. So let's G be a final subgroup of SL2C, and X be a quotient space by the natural action, and Y is a minimal resolution. And then the Dirac Bakay correspondence says that the Dirac category of G coherent sheaves on C2 is equivalent to the bounded Dirac category of coherent sheaves on Y. So this kind of correspondence is given by the following diagram. So C2 X and Y, and then there is a universal family of Hilbert scheme corresponding to this action. So the generic point of W corresponds to O free orbit of G, and then if you take P and Q, and then this functor is given by P pullback and Q push forward, and take G invariance. So for example, if you have OP, so PP is a single one, then this goes to OE. So E is an exceptional locus. So this is union of exceptional divisors. OP goes to OE, and so if you take any irreducible representation of G times OP, then this goes something like OEI minus 1 bracket shifted by 1. So any irreducible representation which is non-trivial corresponds to irreducible exceptional curve, and so. And if you take tensor product with regular representation like C2, and then this is decomposed into irreducible representations, and that corresponds to the extension modulus of these sheaves. So that was the classical Bakay correspondence. And here, as you note, that these are pure sheaves. But the corresponding thing on the right hand side is not sheaves, but shifted sheaves. So in this sense, this equivalence doesn't hold for on the level of abelian category, but you need to go to the other category. So this is one ingredient again. Another ingredient is the following. So suppose that you have a smooth surface. And so minus 1 cup on it, and then you have a Castellanova contraction to a point P, and correspondingly you have a semi-orthogonal decomposition of the Dirac category. So here X is equal to and this part is generated by the exceptional object. So this is called exceptional object. Because it doesn't have any self-extension, and it is simple in the sense that there are no more endomorphism except dilation. So this phi is equivalent free phase factor from y to x, and the rest. So there is some exceptional part. So c is equal to the order. The object such that it is such which are acyclic with respect to n. So this is a kind of kernel with respect to this morphism n. So these are two basic ingredients in this whole project. So actually, this kind of decomposition holds much in much more general situation. So, in any dimension, if you have this kind of the direct image of that structure shape becomes structure shape, and there are no higher direct image, then the quasi-coordinate shape of X is decomposed into this kind of thing. So this kind of decomposition holds always. For example, in this case also. So X and Y are interchanged. But in this case, this morphism satisfies also this one. So you get also this kind of decomposition. The difference is that here, I consider unbounded Dirac category of quasi-coordinate shape. So this is big category. But this is small category. So this is bounded Dirac category of coherent shape. And so this is not so interesting because it holds always. And it doesn't reflect any geometric thing. But here, the resolution, minimal resolution is Kreppel. So that preserve the canonical divisor. So it's a very nice situation. And then if you consider not like this, but something like G equivalent coherent sheaves, then you get equivalence. So this is more interesting than this kind of decomposition.
May I ask a question? So
yes.
Does it hold also if your contraction is not projective? So that one. So sometimes, you know, you have surfaces with non-projective, with a contraction,
which is
non-projective.
This is objective. So this statement holds.
Yeah, this statement holds still.
Yes. So for complex surfaces, yes. Actually, I'm working on a complex number field.
Complex.
Everything is complex number field.
Yes, but there are sometimes, you know, contraction which makes.
Yes. I know. So, like Hopf surface, for example. Okay, so I'd like to combine these two situations into one picture. So, for this purpose, I should replace x by its quotient stack. So, actually, so this is the same as dB of x over g. C2. So instead of x itself, the quotient variety, I take quotient stack, then there is a given. So this is maybe this is denoted by curly x. And then the diagram is like this. So, yeah. So maybe here I write a new diagram. So x, so curly x is about x, and yeah, y, and the fiber product will be maybe that. So then, then this equivalence is pulling back and pushing down the same way. So this is, so the geometric situation is only the contraction, so the morphism. But then, so the content of this kind of equivalence is something like this flip diagram. Mm-hmm. Always, so you have bottom thing and then you have two thing and then there's some upper model and then go up and go down. So this is like flip. Okay, so and the canonical divisor in this case is equal. But the canonical divisor in this case, kx is bigger than ky. Actually, this is ky plus c. So here I ignored the pullback by k. So if I then combine these two things, then there's a conjecture. So let x be a pair such that which has only quotient thing like this, only quotient thing like this, and another pair also quotient thing like this. And locally there exist some generically finite morphism from x hat smooth such that pi star of kx plus b is equal to kx hat. And similarly, y hat to y and pi y star maybe pi x. Ky plus c is ky. So in this way, the coefficient of the Q divisor, boundary divisor P and C, so-called standard, so 1 minus 1 over L, something like that. So depending on the ramification. And X hat need not be reducible, just local covering, but it's subject to X. Okay. So in this situation, if Kx plus B is equal, so they are birations, so there are bigger models like this, P and Q. And I can compare divisors on these varieties on the dominant model, is equal to ky plus c. And then dB of coherent, I just take a lot of coherent. And if there is inequality, then dB of y is decomposed into two parts. Y of dB of x. So here, curly x and curly y stacks, so the x and y dream manifold stacks given by this cover x up and y. So by using these coverings, you get the locally x has quotient of x hat. And so this local structure gives you stack structure, and you can glue together by using this global covering. So you get the three manifold stacks, x, curly x, curly y. So you can divide. And then they are equivalent if the Kalimba divisors is equal, and then, so there is decomposition, semi-orthogonal decomposition. Maybe I should define what is semi-orthogonal decomposition. So in general, that D, we are trying with the category and decomposed into two triangulated subcategories if the following holds. So first of all, home AB here. Home BA is zero for all A in A and for all B in B and for all D in D, there exist A and B, such that there's distinguished triangle like D goes to A, B, like this, right here. So the so this is the first condition, the second condition. First condition means that A and B are orthogonal in one side. B to A, there are no movies. But A to B, there is. So you can formulate this kind of triangle. And the second condition means that the whole category is generated by two subcategories. So the conjecture says that there's some additional, so exceptional component, and here phi is, because phi is fully faithful. And this is conjecture, and there is no counterexample yet, at least. And there are a lot of evidences, but they are all partial. So mainly, after these days, there are positive answers, but in most cases, almost all cases, X and Y are smooth, so positive. B and C are the same. But I'll explain in the toric case that I should consider the boundaries in the course. So minimum model theorem proved using log case. And so of course the non-log case is more important, more basic, but you cannot prove the inductive argument without using logs. So log appears automatically. And also even in the toric case, I need to consider log case in the course of the proof.
So in this case, it's just Modular-Wolf theorem?
No. It's not a theorem. Even in this case, it's quite open.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So Modular-Wolf proved only blow-up, just one blow-up, okay. Smooth center. Okay. So this is part of a very special case of toric test. Also, standard, this is also toric. If I can prove this in toric case, it's automatically extended to toroidal case. So this is kind of this kind of conjecture can be proved locally. So of course it doesn't appear local statement, but the local proof is sufficient.
So you can handle toroidal singularities, yeah? So you will be able to handle toroidal singularities?
Toroidal, but Q-factorial toroidal. Q-factorial toroidal means that only quotient. Abelian quotient. So I can deal with Abelian quotient, but not non-Abelian quotient. Yes. So all Abelian quotients can be handled. Yeah. Okay, so in this case, so maybe the most B biggest impact, which left. Well, so the work which had the biggest impact was Dr. Bridgend. So he treated in the case he mentioned MC3. So in two-dimensional case, everything is clear. Not clear. Actually, SL2 case and smooth case, it's okay. But for singular case, I'll explain, but this is not so clear. But anyway, in dimensional three case, non-null case is proved by Bridgend. And that proof is very interesting. So he constructed, the content of his result is that if you have a flop like this, so in this case kx is equal to ky, and then the derived categories of x and y are given. And how he proved is that he constructed the flopped variety as a moduli space of purpose sheaves on X. And in this way, he proved it is equivalence. So it is quite a highly non-trivial proof, a very interesting proof. And then it is generalized by Chen Junjun and Van den Berg. And then that the higher dimensional case is more special, but for example, cotangent space. So if X is cotangent space of Grassmannian, and this is a Springer, this can be a Springer resolution, some symplectic singularity, and then there is naturally a plot also. So and this case is proved by Kautis and Donovan Siegel and Balan Fabio Kazanko and Hartmann Dyson. This is also interesting because they used the geometric invariant theory to prove this. So they are top. So these two varieties are part of some big stack, and by open restriction they proved this kind of thing. So they found some category which is called window, and by restricting to both of them, they get the equivalence. Yeah, so this is also very interesting. And also in the case of Mackay correspondence, so this case, Mackay case, so if G is a finite subgroup of SL3C, then also this is proved by Bridgend, King Lee. Very impressive work also. So now I'd like to state that this is true in the Turing case. So in the Turing case, everything works very well. So, for example, if X and P, if two pairs are given, and such that KX plus B is equal to KY plus C, then this bidirectional map is decomposed into a sequence of bidirectional maps such that K, then they are connected by primitive changes of And this is already completely non-trivial thing, even in the Torin case. So, for example, this is not proved in the, for the general pairs. And it's a quite interesting problem. So, yeah, maybe I stay. So the level of the K or K plus boundary is like this. Then if you take arbitrary pairs, KY plus C, and this is the bottom level. So minimum model program goes to the bottom. So this is minimum level. And the existence of minimum model is just the termination of this process. So if you go, so it's already proved by Kekkonen and Pilkka Cassini that you can go down. So you can make the level of canonical divisor smaller, but it's not known whether this process terminates. But if the termination holds, then you get minimum model. And if you take two minimum models, then they are connected by flops. So this is also known. But if you take non-minimum model and the same level, yeah. So minimum model, all minimum models have the same level. Okay. So it's easy to see. And they are connected by flops. So this is slightly more difficult. But you can use BCHN to show this. But in the middle of the in the middle level, it's not all, not yet known. They are connected by flops. So someone wants to go to diving in Easter Island. So then you can imagine what this means.
What do you mean by the same level?
So if you take a higher model and the pullback of K plus B and K1 plus C are the same.
Oh, same.
Yeah. Okay. So first of all this solves, and so now in the Torin case. So toric MMP decomposes Dyson map into toric flips and the divisorial contractions. And modify bus spaces. So first two one are birational, but the third one drops the dimension. But this is important because the following picture holds. So if you have, for example, if you have a divisorial contraction, then there is exceptional divisor. So this is divisorial contraction. The exceptional divisor is contracted to some higher codimensional sub-variety. Yeah. After this, then if you restrict the situation, so maybe here you have boundary B and boundary C. Actually, boundary C is just the image of B. And then you can define B of F, B of B, and B of F, such that this is modifiable space. And moreover, if you take a stack associated to the pair, so pair B and B, and like this, then this is smooth morphism. So locally, just direct product. So in this sense, I can reduce to the smooth morphism, and smooth morphism have the fibers are just panels. And this morphism, so if you go to the covering, then they they are just direct product locally.
So in Fano, for Fano, if X is Fano, then DB of covariant X, that's an exceptional collection. That means that the whole DR category is decomposed semi-orthogonally. So this is semi-orthogonal. Semi-orthogonal is the exceptional objects. So I built up the whole thing from Fano case, and then using this kind of inductive statement, I can analyze the whole delta category of polygon varieties. And so in this divisional contraction case, I have also a stack here, and I have a stack here. And there is no morphism from here to here. But
is that the direct category of the curly X in the bottom, script X or script E?
No,
in the exceptional collection statement.
This is only for the fiber of this.
This kind of
simple decomposition, is that only in the toric case?
Only in the toric case. Yeah, of course, it's interesting to know some kind of generalization of this kind of statement. About the spherical varieties. Okay, so, and then the diagram is like this, so X goes to X. So then phi is just q star. So if, so this is FF, if kx plus b is bigger than ay plus c, and psi q star is FF, if kx plus b is causing opposite in that way. So this kind of free phase factor is controlled by the inequalities of the canonical divisor, and then what are the semi-orthogonal opponent? So they are, so this is maybe PQR, and then there is some pull back and push down, and then S1, S2, something, and then so semi-orthogonal components are like this. So DBF, pull back, and push down. And this will become tensor or something. So like this. So this is free phase free embedded into the delta category of X. So first take the base space of the modifier space and smooth pullback, and then twist by some invertible shape. And then I'll go to this. Yeah. In this way, the semi-orthogonal component described as a smaller dimensional yeah, category. So in this case, in this sense, you can decompose everything into smaller pieces. So this is what the derived so Q-factorial means this abelian, only abelian positions in X. So any abelian positions in X is toric. And toric Q-factorial implies abelian positions. They are the same. So abelian thing is kind of one-dimensional thing. The higher dimensional non-commutative place is much more difficult. So for example, this includes Bondar or Orlov case. So smooth blow-up, for example. If Y is smooth, F is smooth, and blow-up is Y, X, and then X, there is no B and so on. And everything is like this. So now I'd like to explain in the title, so how to apply this to this Mackay corresponding case. So now I consider G to be arbitrary finite subgroup of GL3. C. So in the case SN3, it is the Mackay correspondence is proved already by Bridger King Reed. So it how to generalize this. So let H be the intersection with this. Then G over A. So H is a normal subgroup. Quotient group is Z mod R for some R. Then what the Bridger King Reed proved is the following. So C3 modeled by H has a minimal resolution M, so Clapeyron resolution. Clapeyron means minimal, the same in this case, such that dB of C3H is equivalent to dB of M by Bridger King Reed. And in their proof, M is constructed as a moduli space of some G stable. So it's one of the components of a Hilbert scheme of G equivalent Hilbert scheme on C3. So now GR acts on M. So dB of C3 divided by G is equivalent to dB. So, and M is smooth, so this is smooth, and GR is abelian group. So M over GR, so this type has only abelian quotients in it, so I can use toric method. So this is not toric globally, but locally it's toric. There is a concept of maximal resolution.
So there's a minimal resolution, but also a maximal resolution. That's a minimal resolution. So the existence of minimal resolution is already proved by BCHM paper. So let X be a KLT pair. And then there exists minimal resolution. So minimal resolution. Y to X. So the condition is that first Y has only Q factorial terminals, right? Secondly, KY is negative over X. So this is minimal resolution. And so the level. So level of K is like this. So this is K plus B. And the minimal resolution has bottom KY. So since Y is minimal, so this is at the bottom. And then if you blow up Y, Y dash, then the canonical divisor increases. And if you blow up further, then it is above the original level. But up to some point you can blow up.
For the Y, is there also a boundary, BY or something?
No, there is, here I don't consider a boundary. Yeah, so, yeah, there are many variants of this kind of thing. But here, so, for example, to get the concept, let's try to have some example. So this is a surface quotient singularity, and so this is x0, and then the y minimal resolution has two exceptional divisors, so self intersections -4. And so kx is equal to ky, so this is c1, c2, plus 2/3 of c1 plus c2. So this means ky is smaller than kx. Then if you blow up further, so y1 is like this, -5, -1, -5, 2/3. 1/3, 2/3. Then kx is equal to ky 1 plus 2/3, c1 plus c2, +1/3, c3. And still you can pull up 2 points, and then this is equal to ky 2 plus c2, c1 plus c2. +1/3, c3, +0 × c4, +c5. Of course, 0 as a neighbor, just let's make it visible. -5, -6. So this is the maximal resolution. So if you blow up further, then you get negative component on the right hand side. Then, so I can apply this to
this situation, so M over ZR has natural boundary B. So because ZR has codimension 1 fixed locus, maybe. So they contribute to the boundary with standard coefficient. And then I can have a maximal resolution. But this is also maximal resolution of C3 divided by G. Okay. Because they are, because KM over ZR plus B is equal to KX plus BX, where pi star KX plus BX is equal to KC3. And so this is the maximum resolution, and this is toroidal. So in this way, I can decompose the whole category. In this way, so the theorem is like this. So theorem. So TB. Y was the maximum resolution, but this may have three-dimensional terminal singularities, but they are cyclic quasi. So it may be replaced by stack, and with phi, is free phase quantum. What are the complementary components? So Ci is some real category of some varieties, Zi, where Zi are smooth, and dimension of Zi is 0, 1, or 2. For example, if dimension Zi is 0, this means just origin of this. Zi is just origin. And then this is then by exceptional object. And so dimension Zi is 2, then they are just the quotient of a minimal resolution or quotient of reflection hyperplane. So because G is in GL, so there may be quasi reflections inside G. So in that case, there's quasi reflection hyperplane, and then taking quotient by other elements, and then taking mineral resolution. So the dimension one case is not very clear, but this is a fine rational curve. At the moment, I cannot prove that this is embedded in the quotient space C3, but it is finite about this, because there may be some ramification about this fixed locus. Yeah. Okay. So I think it's time now.
I have elementary question. So when you have abelian quotient, the fact that P star of O is all is the same as abelian inside a circle.